You might wonder what causes the sun to create so much heat. Heat on the sun has a very complex process. Why the sun is hot has baffled people for centuries. Maybe God was trying to cook an egg and he left it in the microwave for too long. Well, that's not true. One early idea was that sun is a burning lump of coal. If the sun's heat came from burning coal, gasoline or anything known, it would have burnt out long ago. There must be some other much more powerful fuel. The sun is made up mostly of hydrogen, and the hydrogen in the center of the sun is being squeezed together so much that it actually starts to stick together and form a gas called helium. That is nuclear fission, a process that led to atom bombs and nuclear reactors. This intense pressure creates heat at temperatures that are around 15 million degrees centigrade. That's a lot. This is hot enough to instantly vaporize anything that it had a chance to even come close to it. Work by Albert Einstein helped scientists that when these particles are squeezed together, they can release enough energy to keep the sun shining and keep it hot. Two nuclei of deuterium or heavy hydrogen can fuse together and make a nucleus of helium. A little mass is transformed into a lot of energy. Remember that equation E equal to mc square, where m is the mass and c is the speed of light? Since light travels very, very fast, c square is huge. This explained how the sun could keep shining for billions of years. It all fits together. The temperature in the center of the sun is 15 million degrees centigrade, but the temperature at the surface is much lower at 5700 degrees centigrade. So just imagine how hot the center of the sun is. The Earth is in our solar system in just the right position so that we aren't too close to the sun to get burned to a toast and not too far away to become a planetary snowball. Scientists are more certain about the basic physics that the further you are from a heat source like a campfire, the cooler the temperature should be. The sun's heat expands into the solar system, and the further away it gets, the cooler it is. It takes 8 minutes for any of the sun's heat to reach the Earth, which is 93 million miles away. If you enjoyed or learned anything from this video, remember to give it a thumbs up, and I will appreciate if you hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching.